When I first came here at Stennis, there weren't that many women who were working in the field supporting the tests in the support areas that I started out with. So when I first came here, I had to deal with a lot of technicians who were really sort of surprised to see a woman show up in that role, as well as being a young female. I was probably in my early 20s at the time when I started. So I think there was some time when I had to try to gain their trust in my knowledge and my experience in being an engineer. But I think after maybe a couple of years working out here and working with the technicians on a one-on-one basis, we developed a great relationship, and I haven't had any problems since then. I have been really fortunate to have strong women who've been really inspirational to me in my career. Mainly it's been teachers. I guess the first teacher I can draw inspiration from has been my aunt, who's taught high school math for over 40 years. She's always been that role model for me and always made math approachable to me as a young kid. Besides that, throughout all my high school career, I've always had all female math teachers, which was pretty incredible at that time when you think about it. So math has always been approachable to me as a female. It wasn't something that girls could not do. The first opportunity I had to see an SSME testing was one night, probably 2-3 o'clock in the morning. And I think it was the thing that most inspired me to stay on with NASA and enjoy the things that NASA does. It was a test of the Space Shuttle main engine. It was probably 520 seconds, and I had never seen anything like that. I mean, the night sky lit up with that flame from that engine, as well as the ground was vibrating. And I think I was hooked on testing from that moment on. I've actually had the opportunity to mentor several co-op students or students who are here in our summer intern programs. And oddly enough, it's great to see some of those students who've graduated from college. I mean, they contact me through LinkedIn and see that they've achieved their goals and also have surpassing a lot of those goals. I can remember some of them starting out in our SHARP program. We used to have a program called SHARP, which was for high school students. And they've gone through, graduated from high school, graduated from college, and now they're working in corporate America in an engineering field. So it's really a great pride I have for seeing those women succeed in their chosen careers. I'll tell any female who's about to enter their career as an engineer or a scientist or any of the STEM-related fields to always do your best, always be honest, and always strive for excellence. Never see yourself as different from any of your male counterparts, because the job is a job for an engineer. It's not a job for a female engineer or a male engineer, it's for an engineer.